I was very lucky in my life to have very great teachers, but teachers of significance that have actually done the stuff themselves. They're not just teaching, they have done it. So they have actually something to teach. And so I find myself, because of the wonderful, wonderful education I got through them, that it's really incumbent upon me to teach what little I know to my own students. And I'm very, very fortunate to have some fabulous composition students that work with me, have worked with me, are working with me, and some that are about to start working with me. And I want to mentor them. I want them to have the same life, the same learning that I had when I was growing up as a composer, to understand not only harmony and counterpoint and orchestration and vocal orchestration and all those things, but also what goes behind the notes. To have form and freedom come together as a composer, I think is very important. And so I work very closely with a lot of young composers. And for me, it's one of the great, great things of my life. Being a composer is a very solitary thing. So as a composer, you spend most of your time on your own because you're thinking, and you're writing down and you're structuring and all of those things. And if you're setting text, you have to understand the poetry. And so that's a very solitary thing. There then becomes another side. There's another side to that, which is conducting or attending performances and so on. And I think it's very important for composers of choral music to understand the choir physically, not just in your mind and your ear. So it's important, not necessarily for composers to conduct, but for composers to at least sing. So you have to be in a choir, you have to understand the warmth of it, the power of it, the structure of it. But to conduct is another important thing. Composers conducting their own music can be a double-edged sword, because sometimes composers hear the music in their head and they're not listening to what the choir is doing. So I think it's important for composers to learn conducting and to conduct and really properly learn it. And then, so all of my students, for example, doing doctoral studies with me, have to conduct their own music. So when they write the music, then they conduct the choir. And it's unbelievable to see how the music that they're writing then changes, because they then are confronted with people who are quite happy to tell them what they think about various things. And that feeds as well into the compositional process. So conducting is important. How do I teach conducting is a more difficult question to answer, because of course there's technique that you can teach, which one maybe has learned from great conductors. But then there's something inside someone as a conductor that you can't teach. They have to have that, their personality has to come through them. John Elliott Gardner said that conductor is simply that, you are conducting electricity. You are a conductor of emotion from you to the choir. And that's one of the things they teach here in Westminster, is you have to create personality in your conductor. I have a very good friend of mine called Gordon Graham, who teaches at Princeton Theological Seminary. And Gordon invited me out to talk about music and faith at the seminary. And when I came out to do that, just after the Royal Wedding, he also emailed James Jordan and said, look, would you like to meet Paul? So James said, yes, of course I would. So I met with James and we instantly became friends. We have the same sense of humor, the same view on life, the same kinds of emotional connections. And so we got on and he said, look, you must do something with Williamson Voices. So I came again out here and they premiered, the American premiere of My Could You Fix Us, here in Princeton and also in New York. And it was phenomenal. They are one of the best choirs in the world, there's no doubt about that. And of course, Westminster Choir College is a phenomenal place, because as far as I'm aware, it's the only place in the world that spends their whole time on choral music. Nowhere else does that. And so you end up with the most phenomenal choirs, the most phenomenal singers, the most amazing musicians steeped in choral music. And so I've been here a lot now since that first meeting, and the choirs here perform my music, and it's a joy. And I use that word, the truest sense. The amazing thing about working here is not only that you work with great singers, but there are also many composers. And so when I started working with the choirs, the composers wanted to meet me and show me their music. And so we had a number of sessions with lots of the composers here, and a number of them expressed an interest to continue working with me. And so they came to Aberdeen, Scotland. And I have students from here, Westminster, now working with me at doctoral level, who are, I think, some of the most talented young composers of choral music anywhere in the world. And it's a great honour for me to have them come from here in Westminster to Aberdeen in Scotland to continue their studies and to see them continue to grow. And it's wonderful because we're back here now and they've come back with me, these students who were graduates here this week, and for them to bring back what they've learned in Scotland to where they came from, I think is phenomenal.
Thank you.